Hello guys, today I'll be showing you how to run a PHP project using XAMPP and MySQL. So first thing first, you need to have the XAMPP installed in your system. Then you need to find where you've installed the XAMPP. It's in my case, it's in drive C. So there is a XAMPP folder. I'm going inside the folder. The second thing I need to do is to find the XAMPP control file actually runs the XAMPP. I need to open it, and you can see that in the XAMPP, you have the option to install Apache, MySQL, FileZilla, Mercury, and Tomcat. I've only installed two things. The PHP and Apache isn't necessary, actually. For the MySQL, you have the option to install that. I'm clicking on the start buttons. So once I do that, both of them are actually running. Now, the second thing I need to do is to be inside the XAMPP folder, and I need to go to the HD docs here. In the HD docs, you need to create a new folder where you're gonna place or create your PHP files to run them. So I'm gonna create a new folder here like that. And here I'm gonna write something like your PHP project and go inside the PHP project. Now we need to create the files to run. I'm gonna right click and I'm gonna open the terminal. And I'm gonna try to open the IDE in this folder, which is why I just run the terminal, by the way. So the PHP project, your PHP project folder is empty for now. I'm gonna click on the new file and I'm gonna write the name. It can be anything. For example, I'm writing in next.php. So now this is the PHP file and it's gonna run in the XAMPP. How to do that? Let's test this. The very first thing we need is to place the PHP tags like this. And now I'm going to run the PHP command echo. And whatever I want to echo or print on the screen, I'm going to write it. The PHP project runs. Perfect. Perfect. Okay, now the ending quote. And we need to test it now. For that reason, I'm going to open the browser to see if it works. So here it is. I'm going to write localhost slash your PHP project. And I need to press the enter key. And there you go. It actually here, you can see that the PHP project runs. But we need to make sure that the Apache is actually running. For now, the MySQL has no role, but the Apache has to be run. So it's running. And the folder we've created, this folder, the your PHP project folder, has to be inside the HD docs folder. These two things are necessary to run the PHP project in the XAMPP. So now we need to connect the MySQL with our project. So what we need to do is we need to go back a little and it means XAMPP folder, and we need to open the XAMPP control again. We need to see if the MySQL is running or not. It's running because it's green. We just clicked there when we pressed the start button for the Apache module, and that's great. Okay, because it's running, so I'm gonna go to the browser again and I'm gonna write PHP my admin. It opened. That means it's absolutely working. The next thing is we need to connect the next thing is we need to have the username and the password to connect the MySQL with our project. So here it is. I just made a new username. Okay, and I gave it a password. I'm gonna go with this username. So how we do that? Just go inside the PHP tag again, and I'm gonna create a new variable, CONN. It can be anything, by the way, and it needs a few information. First thing is MySQLi connect the method, which actually helps us connect with the database. And then the second thing is we need to write the credentials. First thing first, the name of the server. It's absolutely localhost. It could be any website if I was trying to get some absolute database. So I could have added a website here or a web address, but it's, you know, it's inside our system. So I'm adding the localhost. The second thing is the username. The username was learn.php. The third thing is the password. I wrote something like ASD123. You can write anything you want. Now, technically, we've connected with the database, but we need to check if everything is going fine. So I'm going to apply the if and else statement. If I'm asking if this variable returns false, if this returns false, then what should happen? Die. I'm simply asking to die. Every process of this page will be stopped. And connection failed. And dot, I'm concatenating the MySQLi connect error. Spelling should be corrected. Okay, that's fine. Now, I'm going to go to the browser back. Okay, I'm going to refresh it and everything looks fine. Okay, I got no error. But let's see how the error would look. For example, I'm changing the password. The last one is a password. I'm adding 4. So absolutely, the spelling is wrong now. So we should get the error. And if I refresh that, you can see that. I got an error. You can see that. But again, if I make it correct, then the error would go. Now, let's see the browser. I'm going to go to the browser here, and I'm going to refresh the page, and the error goes. So that's how, my friends, you can connect the MySQL with the PHP projects, and that's how you can run your PHP project in XAMPP.